Trivia Showdown. Once again, I am Matt, and joining me today is
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Douglas Parcells. I am excited to be calling this match with the Reely Trivia Showdown.
Yeah, you are? That's all you got to say?
What else do you need to say? We have great contenders coming around. We have a great match coming up.
Okay. Well, to tell us more about these contenders, we're going to have their managers come in. And these managers are their teammates, so let's bring them in. First off, we have Colin, the mouth of the South, Morris. Colin, how you doing tonight?
I'm struggling, Matt.
You're struggling? All right.
I'm trying to come off a tough loss to the mystery man. But what I'm here to do is I'm here to provide fire, some swagger to a man who needs no introduction.
Well, he'll be getting one today.
From me. An amazing introduction, by the way, and none of you are ready for it. None of you deserve it.
Well,
this
joining...
man. Oh,
it's okay. We all choke every once in a while. Now, that said, my opponent, my partner, is going to destroy. He is going to win. And you know what? If he doesn't, we're going to have fun. That is what we do here at the Kids at Heart, baby. I cannot wait. I cannot wait to eventually partner up with this guy. We are going to have the greatest time in the entire world. I am just so excited for my partner here. He's going to kick ass, take names, and I'm ready for Chris Anthony Lopez.
That's cute that you're eventually excited, but I hang out with my partner every single week for hours on end, hosting the Ultimate Schmodown Show live every Friday night at 7 p.m. Eastern time, where we break down and analyze the greatest movie trivia showdown show besides this on the face of the interwebs. And it is time to recognize that Bogz is here to set the record straight, that we are here to claim all the belts. All the belts. They're ours. They're going to every episode of the Ultimate Showdown Show, you guys can come and watch. Our belts.
Well, you got to win one to start one, and you got to prove it here in this league. And I cannot wait for my friend Chris Anthony Lopez, already challenged for a belt himself. But like I said, here to have fun. That's what the Kids at Heart do. We are here to have fun. And without further ado, I think it's about time that we bring him in.
Well, the Kids at Heart have a podcast too, right?
The Kids at Heart, of course, we have a podcast where we talk about fun wrestling related things every single week. And I just can't wait to see my buddy Chris Anthony Lopez out there challenging Mr. Bogz.
All right. Well, without
there is a lot of talk in this stream right now. You might as well think that it's Jay Leno and Jimmy Fallon.
Yeah. So without further ado, let's bring in these competitors. Introducing first, we have coming in his debut, the one and the only Pretty Brown Bogz.
I'm not even your type, but you got my attention for something that I like. Let's get out this club, it's time to go. It's time. So I got some questions I need to know.
Who's giving you all your love? Who's bringing you all your pain? Who's making sure that
you're muted.
I'm sorry, but that track is fire. That track is fire. I'm ready. We've been training. We're coming to take over your league. Chris, me and Chris don't get along, so we're going to get it on. Matt, I want your belt. I want your bet here in the UK. I'll pay for that FedEx. I want that belt. I want your show. I'm coming for it all. But we are going to have fun. But yeah, let's get on, man. I've been looking forward to this. So big shout out to you guys for having us on. But unfortunately, this is the Ultimate Schmodown Show boys taking over.
They can try to take over. It's hard when the Ultimate Schmodown boys already have a record of 0-1.
Well, you know, we'll get there. We'll get there.
Zeros. I alone have a record of 5-0.
Well, you know, We'll stand up to you. Don't worry.
That I, a person who said he will lose all of his matches, has a better record than your entire team right now.
Listen, I'm not even started yet. What are you talking about? I want you. I'll have you all one by one. I'll line you all up.
What you need is a fire extinguisher because it looks like your house is on fire.
That's a fire entrance, that's cool. Yeah.
Yeah, to an extent, yeah, it's all smoke up our butt.
It might be. Well, let's see. I was impressed with Chris's match against you, Matt. I did watch that. But yeah, let's see what he's got today.
All right, well, let's drop you right now, and we're gonna bring in Chris. Introducing second, we have the personality himself, Chris Anthony Lopez.
Oh snap! Here we go. Let me take my mask off because you know there's a lot of stuff going on in the world right now, especially you know over here at Bogz. You're out here. Just, you know, dodging the mess that is America. But you know what isn't a mess? Me in the Reely Trivia Showdown. Because, yeah, I've had some L's. It's okay. People can take some L's. But I'm out here bringing the heat every single time. You saw my match against Matt. You just said it. Like, I get better every single time I play. And I'm just out here trying to not only be the best for me, not only be the best for my team, the kids at heart, be the best for Spin from the Reel every single Wednesday on the Who Are They Reel Entertainment YouTube channel. And I'm going to be the best for this league because God knows it needs it. So, I mean, good luck to you, Bogz. I mean, pretty brown, so am I. You're not the only one that's pretty brown. I'm out here, I'm a twofer. Twofer Brownski. So all I got to say is good luck to you. And this ends at the Reely Trivia Showdown, baby. That's what's up. Bring my mans in. I want to see Nick. Give me Nick, baby. I want to see my boy. What's up? Yeah.
Collective records aside, I look forward to my match with Taylor Cleek, the Encourager. That's who it is. Tonight. But right now, I look forward to seeing my boy.
It's already happened.
Well, okay, my match with Taylor has already happened. We don't really talk about this stuff ever. So, I look forward to seeing my boy get this W here today because we're going to own singles. We're going to own teams. And you know what? When I say that I represent winners, it doesn't mean that it doesn't come from a person that I don't even represent. I'm here to talk. I'm here to speak for my boy, my co-host, Chris Anthony Lopez. Can't wait. Can't wait.
Damn right. And yeah, like, I mean, Colin, I heard him saying his piece, you know, he is, you know, talking about his show every Friday, but I have a show every Friday too. It's called Wrestle Reel. Nick already mentioned it, but you know, 6 p.m. Eastern, Wrestle Reel, talk about all the latest and greatest and everything that we want to talk about in wrestling because it's the most unorthodox wrestling show on the face of the earth. Wrestle Reel every single Friday. Who Are They? Real Entertainment, Mouth of the South. Man, get out of here, Mouth of the South. I don't want to shut your mouth, boy. Let's do this thing. Let's do it.
All right, well, we're going to bring Bogz back in now.
What's going on, okay, Bogz?
Okay. Good? Yeah, I'm good, man. How you doing?
That was a fire track. I'm not going to front. I'm like,
yes. Jacquees, man. Shout out to Jacquees, one of my favorites out there.
Jacquees is good, man.
Mm-hmm. He's fire.
Let's do it. Let's do the damn thing.
All right. Man, that's it. Well, before we do the damn thing, we got to go over the rules. So,
general rules. Competitors will be given 3 repeats per match. Competitors will be given 1 challenge per match. If they use their challenge and win the subsequent ruling, they get to keep their challenge to use again. If they use the subsequent ruling, they lose their challenge for the rest of the match.
And let's hear those round 1 rules.
Round 1 official rules. 8 questions in random categories are given to all competitors. Competitors have 15 seconds to write their answer down. Answers must be said aloud when revealing response, and all questions are worth 1 point. A perfect round triggers a 1-point bonus question.
All right. And Colin, to answer your question in the private chat, Chris asked for it. If Bogz had asked for it, I would have given it to you.
Okay. My bad. No worries.
I don't want to hear
I'll see him after. I'll see him after.
You want to come on here with me, Colin?
Colin, we didn't know the rules. We don't know the rules.
I thought we follow by the rules of the greats, and this is what they do. You ask for it. They don't ask for it.
It's an intro. It's an intro. So
we're courteous. We're not a bunch of rudies. Come on, the South. Speak up.
Speak up. You couldn't hear me from backstage. This is where you were too for a little while as well. Sorry. Couldn't hear you back there. All I can hear is just talk. Hey, Bogz, let's get down to business and let's defeat this guy. Let's get on with what we came here to do, baby. We know what we came here to do. We came here to play. We play to win the game.
Let's do it.
All right. Now that things are evened out,
call us Beverly Hills Cop because the heat is on.
Yes. All right.
I hope that's not one of the questions.
No, that is not. All right. So, Bogz, are you ready to show down?
Yes, bro. Let's do it.
Chris, are you ready to show down?
No, but let's get this over with.
All right. Douglas, take it away.
Let's get ready to show down!
Thank you. All right, round one, question one is in the realm of famous actors and actresses. In Anchorman 2, what famous actor represents ESPN during the brawl?
Oh.
ESPN is a wonderful channel, and I wish to be on there one day.
I thought you did the horse races on there.
Is that my brother?
And in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, Bogz, what do you got?
No idea. Paul Rudd?
Oh, no. Did I freeze out?
No.
No, no.
No!
What?
He's not frozen for me.
Yeah, Matt, what are you talking about? He's tripping, bro.
Yeah, he's completely good for me.
Hey, Luke, can you still see me? Or Doug, yes. Can you still see me?
Yes, I can see.
Fantastic. Well, is the correct answer Will Smith?
Yes, it is Will Smith. That's a point to Chris.
Thank you, sir. We can just keep going. Go ahead.
Question is in the realm of Leonardo DiCaprio. In Titanic, Leonardo DiCaprio plays Jack, who is a talented what? I can tell you right now, he is not a talented lifeguard, but... And in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Chris Anthony Lopez, what is your answer?
A painter?
Will we take that?
Yes.
Yes, we will take that. That is correct.
I didn't have it.
What's the score?
Bogz did not have it.
What's the score right now? Because
it is 2-0. He was a talented artist.
Oh, I know. I know one of those.
Paint me like one of your French girls, Leonardo DiCaprio.
All right. On to number 3. In the realm of Nick Cage, who plays Dave, Balthazar's apprentice, and the Sorcerer's apprentice? Thank you for holding the fort down while my computer decided to just the shit real quick, Doug.
I tried my hardest.
You did well.
2-1.
Bogz.
Absolutely no idea. Jamie Bell?
That is incorrect. Chris?
Jay Baruchel?
That is correct. For another point.
It is 3-0.
All right.
This is an interesting match. Of course, we know that it is not over till the fat lady sings. So, in the realm of animated films, what actress provides the voice for Tigress in Kung Fu Panda? And in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Chris, what do you got?
Angelina Jolie.
That is correct.
Correct.
Oh, hell on earth.
This guy's on fire. I said Renee Zellweger. Yes, I didn't know.
Wow.
What the hell?
Oz's house is not on fire right now.
No, I think he's got answer to the questions here.
No, I didn't say he didn't.
He's on fire.
All right. Question number 5. In the realm of young adult adaptations, what is the name of Star's friend who is killed by the police in The Hate U Give?
Not funny. Prince Anthony not funny.
Is laughing. See, this game right now, one of these fighters is playing football and the other is playing football.
And in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Bogz, what do you got?
No idea. Emma?
It's no. Good. Chris, what do you have?
Devin?
Looking for Khalil.
Khalil. See,
now,
perfect round is gone off the table.
Hold on, let me get another pen real fast.
He's running.
Bogz, what the hell's going on, man?
Like, these are some hard questions. I got 6 points in the first round and in Collins' match. I can't. What the hell? They're way harder.
Real? That give me point of Leonardo DiCaprio and Titanic is harder.
I don't remember if he was like a painter because he plays cars at the start. He's a dancer. Then he paints as well. So I was like, I didn't know which one.
All right.
So Man of Mystery could have been an answer.
Yeah.
All right.
So in the realm of the Coen brothers, what alcoholic beverage is the dude's drink of choice in The Big Lebowski?
I got to ask Doug, you ever have one of these?
Yes, I have had many.
They're my go-to also because of this movie.
It ruined my first marriage.
Oh, wow. And then 5.
Well, I blame her.
3, 2, 1. Chris, what do you got?
I have such a troubled history with this movie. Gin and tonic?
That is incorrect, Bogz.
Don't remember. I said Bacardi.
We're looking for White Russian.
That's me.
I was going to say White Rum.
All right.
Bacardi's my drink of choice.
And moving on to question number 7 in the realm of fantasy sci-fi. In 2016's Power Rangers, which member of the Rangers team does Rita Repulsa kill?
See, I dropped off of Power Rangers after I was 6 years old, and I saw them doing all those athletic jumps. And then I said, I can't do this. So then I quit.
You'd like the new one, Doug. I'm pretty sure it's very entertaining, young adult, and coming of age film, honestly. So,
do they explode the same way?
And 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, what do you got for me, Bogz?
No idea. Yellow Ranger. I guess.
Incorrect. Chris, what do you?
2 things. One, it was 2017's Power Rangers. The correct answer is the Red Ranger.
That is incorrect. Billy, the Blue Ranger.
I challenge.
We have a challenge.
Do you want to rectify that challenge or
Zordon, beginning of the movie?
No, we're talking about team.
We're talking about Billy.
You didn't specify what Power Ranger though. Zordon is the Red Ranger.
I said the team. We didn't say at the beginning.
But there was a team in the beginning.
I mean, that is one of two.
It was two of them at the beginning of the movie, and then it was a whole team. We would have said,
who did Rita Repulsa turn on? What Power Rangers? And Zordon didn't die. He literally, his body is behind that wall. He's not floating dead.
Okay.
Billy does die. I will give them that. But
yeah.
Zordon doesn't die. He's just encapsulated.
No one really dies in that movie. Chris. No one died.
Chris, you've scored points. Let's go. Just keep going.
Billy.
Hey, Bogz, you got this, baby. Let's turn this around. Let's go.
I got nothing so far.
All right. So after that challenge. Chris. We're going to let Chris keep his challenge because Nick's just like, Billy's the one who died. All right. After that, that is not a challenge. Nick decided not to make it a challenge. As Chris's manager, he has the right to. He wants to save it. So it's as stands. The answer is Billy, Blue Ranger. So moving on, Doug, take us to the last question of this round.
And in the realm of box office bombs, in 2015's Fantastic Four, what member of the team gets trapped in the other dimension?
Member. My apologies for the spelling mishap.
What member? Didn't we say that we had no typos this time?
I don't. Yeah, and in five.
I apologize. My report sometimes wrong.
Three, two,
repeat.
Oh,
first repeat for Bogz.
In 2015's Fantastic Four, what member of the team gets trapped in the other dimension?
Did you ever see this, Doug?
Yes, and like I said, the White Russians made me forget it. Thank God.
And in five, four, three, two, one. Pens down, pens down. All right. What do you got for me, Chris?
I swear to God, if this is Reed Richards.
That is incorrect.
I've got the Thing, Jamie Bell's character.
That is incorrect. Incorrect. We're looking for Victor Von Doom.
Damn. Damn.
All right. And with that, we have Chris with a lead of 4-0.
0. Wow, this is a real barn burner.
It's anyone's game still, so let's bring in their managers.
Yeah, do not ever let it say.
I love the first 45 minutes of that movie. I want the record to show.
Yes, no, but
I second that notion.
Yes, I agreed.
Nick, he didn't specify.
Why do they chase him in the forest?
Can I talk to my competitor?
Yeah, well, that's what you brought up. Yeah.
Okay. That's what you brought up. Let's get rid of the other two then.
Oh.
That's fair. Well, I talked to my boy one-on-one. Listen, you know, I wouldn't challenge it because unfortunately I did know the answers to that question. That said,
I crossed my brain, but oh God.
My friend. Yeah. Remember, yeah. I want you to remember two things.
Yeah.
I want you to remember two things. Mm-hmm. You scored points. That's one. Mm-hmm. Well, three things. Have fun. You scored points. He did not. Embarrassing. Yeah. And the only mouth of the South is Jimmy Hart.
I second that note.
Let's remember that. There is an imposter mouth of the South out there. The only mouth of the South is Jimmy Hart. We're wrestling fans. Wrestle real. Kids at heart. Mm-hmm. Jimmy Hart. Let's go.
All right. Well, we're going to drop you two and give Bogz and Chris or Colin their moment in the sun.
Yo, you can get Chris out of here. So listen, all right, get all this smoke and mirrors and actually get some more of that smoke up in here. What were you smoking?
It's like some vape thing. Did a little fire there. I'm sorry, but embarrassing. Let me say, the first round's supposed to be able to get points. Like, you're supposed to be quite easy to get points. I get no points, I mean, that's a reflection on the question, Ryan, not me.
They're going to rename you the Pretty Brown Bandit after this round because you're going to be stealing so many points here from this man. I'm going to see so many steals from you. I'm going to see wheel play from you right here that we ain't never seen before. All right?
Yeah, man. Let's do it. I'm enjoying it.
You got one shot, one opportunity. But we have more opportunities after this. So if you mess up, it's all right. But
it's okay, man.
I still love you.
I'm all good.
It's all good.
I didn't know any of them apart from maybe the last one. They were all a bit. Too deep for me. Anyway.
All right. Well, let's bring up
going on.
Let's bring up those round two official rules.
Round two official rules. Each competitor spins the category wheel. Can respin the wheel once, unless wheel lands on opponent's choice. Competitor will get four questions from chosen category. Questions are worth 2 points or 1 point if multiple choice is chosen. Opponents may steal if competitor gives incorrect answer.
All right, so Chris, you have the lead. We're gonna drop, or do you want to spin first or second?
Oh, I'm totally spinning second.
All right, so we're gonna drop you right here and bring Colin back in.
Okay, that seemed a little too cocky. I don't like that vibe. All right, let's take that vibe, throw it out the window, and let's supplant this with some new shit. How are you feeling here? You doing?
Yeah, I mean, all right.
I know your strengths. I know how strong you are in your strengths.
I've got a few strengths on there, ain't gonna lie.
But I know. I see a lot of good stuff there. Might as well forget it. I don't see a lot of bad stuff. My wheel looks like...
I can't see every option. Can you zoom in a little bit?
There's a Pixar on the left if you can't see that.
So where the click to spin is, I can't see these ones.
So Spielberg, Vin Diesel, and Pixar.
Enhance.
All right. Are you ready to spin?
Yeah, man. Let's do it.
Spin that. Right. Let's go. The spin is in. The spin is in.
Spin is in.
I don't know what I've been talking about.
Oh, no.
Ronan's choice.
Okay.
He knows nothing about you.
Choice for
Chris. He knows anything about you.
All right, we're gonna bring you
just Chris. You're pretty, brown, and beautiful.
That's it.
That's all he needs to know.
All right. Don't talk over us, gentlemen. Don't talk over us. We have an important thing going on.
Here, I'll drop them real quick.
Thank you.
Read off all the what to call it, all the wool slices.
We have DCEU, coming of age, Oscar films, Hitchcock, Pixar, Spielberg, Vin Diesel, and Star Wars.
Okay, Nick, two things before. Actually, Colin's right about one thing. I don't know this man.
You don't.
But all I can do is give him one of my strengths and hope for the best.
You can. Here's the thing that I've learned about him in this match so far is that he doesn't know anything about movies because he hasn't scored a point yet. Now, you have a big opportunity here to pick something
that
you might enjoy. You have something to pick and enjoy. I just want you to remember two words before I leave you here. Kevin Owens. KO. Let's
Five,
go.
Four.
We're three, going with
two,
DC Extended
one. Universe. All right. DCEU. All right. DCEU, are you ready, Bogz?
Okay. Yeah, man. Let's go. Let's do it. Let's see this knockout.
All right. Well, I will ask Bogz his questions in the DCEU.
Okay.
Your first question.
Down, do I?
No, you don't. Just hands up, guys. Hands where you can see them. The first question in the DCEU. In Birds of Prey, the fantabulous emancipation of one Harley Quinn, what type of jewel is the Bernadelli Stone?
Multiple choice.
Your options are ruby, sapphire, emerald, or diamond.
C
would be emerald, and that would be incorrect. Chris, for a 1 point steal, the question is, in Birds of Prey, the fantabulous emancipation of one Harley Quinn, what type of jewel is the Bernadelli Stone? Your options are ruby, sapphire, emerald, or diamond.
The Bernadelli Stone is a diamond.
That is correct for 1 point.
Correct.
All right. Question number two in the realm of DCEU. Who informs Arthur that his mother is dead in Aquaman?
Multiple choice.
Your options are Orm, Volko, Mira, his father.
His father?
That is incorrect. Chris, for a chance to steal. The question is, who informs Arthur that his mother is dead in Aquaman? Your options are Orm, Volko, Mira, his father.
Shot in the dark. Mira.
That is incorrect. We're looking for Volko. Willem Dafoe, people. Yeah. Willem Dafoe.
Yeah.
All right. Question number three in the realm of DCEU. In Justice League, what does Barry say he uses his suit for when Bruce begins to talk to him about it?
Multiple choice.
All right. Your options are bobsledding, skiing, competitive ice skating, or snowboarding.
See?
Competitive ice skating is correct for 1 point, and Bogz is on the board. All right.
About time.
Your final question in the realm of DCEU is, who plays Thomas Wayne in Dawn of Batman versus Superman, Dawn of Justice? And
do multiple.
Your options are Ben Affleck, Michael Keaton, Val Kilmer, or Jeffrey Dean Morgan.
Did I get the options again? I didn't hear all of them.
That was your options are Ben Affleck, Michael Keaton, Val Kilmer, or Jeffrey Dean Morgan.
D.
That is correct for 1 point.
Kidding me.
All right. And we're going to bring, after that, we have a score of 5-2, and we're going to bring the wheel back up, and we're going to drop Bogz real quick and bring Nick back in.
Hey, he knows how to guess about movies. Look at that.
What the hell is that last multiple choice? Jesus.
Ben Affleck. Like, what kind of an answer is that? All right, buddy, let's
go. Who wrote these questions?
I would love to know. Let's do the same thing. For the love of God. Got this wheel blows. Come on!
Spielberg.
Steven Spielberg.
Oh, Jesus. Okay.
We're actually looking for Ronald Spielberg, but who do you think that do you think you can handle this, or do you want to spin?
I would like to think I can handle this, but at the same time,
I'm a star.
I want to spin away because freaking Hitchcock is on there. Really, it's the only one I'm afraid of. An opponent's choice, obviously.
Well, you just gave your opponent the thing to pick, unfortunately. Not that he would probably get anything right in that sense. All right. Well, would you like to try again?
Yeah, screw it. Screw it. We'll do it live.
Wow. Risky play by Chris Anthony Lopez.
No. Oh, no. I already regret my decision.
Oh shit!
Wow, this is wonderful.
Take this.
That was a wonderful spin.
Now, what's the score again? Can you give me a score update here?
It's 2-2.
5-2. If he gets all of his questions correct, he wins the match.
If he gets all of his questions correct, he wins. If he gets three right, and then on the 2-pointer and a multiple choice. Oh no, he does have to get all of them right to win.
Kevin Owens. Well, right. You got this, my friend.
5-2.
Oh, okay. Shit, I have no idea. Okay, let's go.
All right.
I'm ready for this. Ready.
So bring Bogz back in.
I am.
And then we will get onto it. This is exciting, everyone. This is a very exciting match, and I am so glad that I can be part of it.
I don't like the smile on Bogz's face. I'm scared now.
Man, I don't know. I'm having fun, man. It's my first ever match, so, you know, let's do it. Let's see what happens. Go for that KO, man. Why not?
All right, let's go.
All right, Chris. Mm-hmm. For Pixar, in Toy Story, what was the drink being dispensed in Pizza Planet?
That's one hell of a 2-point question. I need to hear the multiple choice, please.
We have Ranger Juice, Moon Juice, Alien Slime, and Alien Sludge.
Oh, I hate you. Alien Sludge?
Incorrect. It was Alien Slime. No. Fuck.
You know that, Bogz?
Sorry, Bogz.
I did it.
Give him
I'm gonna give him another question from
Give him another question.
From the so we're gonna My give bad. Him yeah we're gonna give him another question with the multiple choice. All right. In the world of Pixar. What car brand is Sally Carrera in Cars?
Oh
And the multiple choice options are, because Chris had to go multiple choice, Porsche, Corvette, Cobra, or Ferrari.
I'll go C.
C would be Cobra, and that is incorrect. You're looking for Porsche. All right.
All right.
Now, if questions? I can keep my mouth shut after, if anyone gets this incorrect. Okay. So, what Toy Story cast member provided the voice of the Yeti monster in Monsters, Inc.?
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. I got snow cones. I need to hear his voice. All right, his name. Multiple choice.
Multiple choice. You have Don Rickles, Jim Varney, Wallace Shawn, and John Ratzenberger.
It's John Ratzenberger. How the hell is that?
That is correct.
Okay.
We should mention we will officially be going into round three, so anything can happen.
Damn it.
It is okay. I do not know his name either.
I need it. Go ahead.
If he needs to go to multiple choice for this one, I'll read the names because I know the correct pronunciation for the.
Okay. So, what is the name of Jack-Jack's babysitter in The Incredibles?
Oh my God.
I know this. I think I know how to pronounce it.
Lou, you have your phone on you? I'll text it to you.
Oh my God.
No, I don't.
Okay.
Oh my God. I'm looking at her damn teeth. You have braces. Let me hear her names. The names? Multiple choice, please.
All right.
Your options are Kaylee, Kari, Katie, Carrie.
Fuck you, Matt. Say one more time.
All right, that's just free multiple choice repeat. Your options are Kaylee, Kari, Katie, or Carrie? And in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Katie!
Time's up.
What the?
And it's you're wrong anyways.
You're the worst, Burr.
Okay. Bogz, the question is, what is the name of Jack-Jack's babysitter in The Incredibles? And your options are Kaylee, Kari, Katie, or Carrie?
Hey.
That is incorrect. We're looking for Kari.
Kari. I gotta go with my damn gut. All right.
Continue, Douglas.
And for your last Pixar question, in Coco, who provides the voice for Ernesto de la Cruz?
Oh, Jesus. Oh, come on. Give me the multiple choice.
You have Jamie Kamel, Benjamin Bratt.
Iglesias. Oh, it's Benjamin Bratt.
That is correct for 1 point.
Damn it.
All right, so it's still anyone's game going into round three.
This is a nail biter, folks.
What's the score?
The score is 7-2. So, Bog, you're still in this.
Okay.
All right, so let's bring up those round three official rules before we bring in your managers.
Round three official rules. Competitors will pick three numbers that will correspond to three random categories between 1 and 20. Each competitor gets 3 questions. Questions are worth 2, 3, and 5 points. No stealing or multiple choice this round.
All right, let's bring in these managers.
I just wanted to be Robert Pattinson's Batman for a second. Sorry.
I thought you were going for a retribution type of thing.
Yes. I am T-Bar. All right. So, Chris, great round. You got this. I'm proud of you. You're going to do great.
Thank you.
Colin, you're up. Colin,
Anyway. Oh, sorry. Were they saying something? I couldn't hear what they were saying. Doesn't matter. Yeah, all that matters is right now that you are going to come back. You're going to win this match. Talk a big game, and I can feel a comeback coming. I feel a wave coming.
I'm warmed up now.
All the way across the Atlantic.
I thought there were hard points on both sides.
Let me see that Jolly Roger. Let me see that Union Jack. Let me see it fly, baby. Let me see it fly.
We're about to break this place
with a win.
I've seen some stranger things happen, so let's do it, man.
All right.
Let's go.
We're going to drop these managers. Oh. All right, Chris, you're in the lead, so what are you choosing for your numbers?
It's out of 20, right?
Yep, one to 20.
9, 2, and 15.
Bogz?
7, 8, 6.
7, 8, and 6. Wow. Okay. All right. I'll start it off.
In that order.
All right. Bogz, your first question. In the you chose category number 7, which corresponds with cult classics. Okay. Kurt Russell appears as Jack Burton in what John Carpenter film?
The Thing.
That is incorrect. We're looking for Big Trouble in Little China, Jack Burton.
I didn't know his name. I know obviously John Carpenter was a thing, but
yes. Yeah. All right. This is your 3-pointer. You now have to hit your 3 and your 5 to stay in this match. What high you chose number 8, which corresponds with Spike Lee.
Okay.
What high-ranking member of the KKK does Ron Stallworth have phone conversations with in Black Klansman?
So when you say high-ranking, do you want the character's name, the rank, or
the character's name? Just the character's name.
See, I know he's the head, but his name.
And in 5.
Repeat.
All right, you have one repeat after this. What high-ranking member of the KKK does Ron Stallworth have phone conversations with in Black Klansman? His name. And then 5, 4.
He's last repeat. 3.
All right. What high-ranking member of the KKK does Ron Stallworth have phone conversations with in Black Klansman?
I know the actor. I know what he looks like.
5.
Character's name. I'm going to say 4. Eric, something like that.
And your winner!
Wait.
No. Not correct, because I pulled a Lou.
No, you pulled a Nick.
I pulled a Nicholas.
Wow.
We are seeming very professional right now to the other people coming in.
What are we doing?
All right. You have a chance to tie it right here with your 5-pointer, which corresponds with the realm of Zack Snyder.
Okay.
Hugo Weaving provides the voice to which owl in The Legend of the Guardians, the Owls of Ga'Hoole?
I didn't even hear all of that question. Which owl?
Yeah, which owl does Hugo Weaving provide the voice for?
Okay. No idea.
5, 4.
Which owl?
3.
The blue one? 2. I don't know what that even
means. And your winner!
Finally,
a TKO is the one and the only Chris Anthony Lopez. We're looking for Noctis. Noctis.
What? No idea.
All right, we're going to drop Chris real quick, and we're going to bring in Bogz manager. How you guys doing? Not a great week for the guys at the Ultimate Showdown show.
That was bullshit. I'm sorry. like, what the hell? You're asking me an ESPN question and
Bogz, yeah. Look, I'm going to send you my 11th grade history book, okay? We're going to get you studied up on this American history. All right, actually, that's a bad idea. 11th grade history with South Carolina history. You don't want any of that because it's not really even history. It's all lies. It's all propaganda. Lies. You don't that's want none lies. Of that. You're going to give you some real
I'm
stuff.
I'm glad you realized that, Colin. I'm glad you realized that.
No, honestly, I've played along with – I think maybe I've watched two or three of your guys' matches. I've won every time. So for I think that should
that's
be
how
level
I feel too, bro.
This match, it was like, what? Colin, how many questions did you get in round one? Tell the truth.
Me?
Yeah.
Oh, I got 6 points.
So maybe it's just me, but I got 6 points in your match. Like, how can I get no points and then like no points in my own round and then no points in round? I got two steals. That's some bullshit.
Let's come on. It's all good. See, the question right. The question right. Here's the attitude. We know the attitude. We both know what we did wrong. That's a thing that a lot of losing teams don't know. A lot of losing teams don't know what the problem is. We know exactly what the problem is.
So hold on. Okay, I didn't get any questions right in my first round. In my own second round and in the third round. Is that right, Bogz? Even one easy question at all. That was nothing. That was like, what? So come on, you got to give a couple at least. Even in the Showdown, there's a couple of easy ones that, okay, get people warmed in. So I don't know. I'm just saying. Despicable, disgusting.
Right? We'll take what we get right now. But if you. We got this.
No. To be honest, enjoyed it. You know, it was a TKO, but at least I didn't get knocked out. So.
Yeah, you didn't get knocked out. But you guys are actually going to be playing each other next. So how are you feeling about that?
Oh, we already know how that's going to go.
Yeah.
Maybe a shit show. Either way.
Yeah.
The ultimate Showdown Civil War, Tusk Civil War.
Yeah, looks like it.
Looks, well, you want to be Iron Man or am I going to be Iron Man? You can be Cap or, what are we doing here? Or is this like some Captain Marvel Civil War 2 stuff?
Yeah, I can be. You can pick. I'll be the side bit on the side, the sidekick.
All right. Let's do this.
The real
I'll be Iron Man. Yeah. Well done, Chris. You done well?
Yeah. Let's not beat around the bush here. Chris played an excellent match.
Two questions.
Let's just get one thing straight. The Ultimate Showdown Show will be back.
Yes.
We will be back.
All right, we're going to drop you two real quick, and we're going to bring on Chris and Nick.
I mean, dude, like if Express, I mean, he might need Express VPN or something like that to be able to like watch Black Klansman on like his British TV or something like that. Oh, you could watch it anywhere. Anyways, what a match. What a great match from my friend here, my partner. Hey, we talk a lot of smack. It's fun. What a great start to their – I mean, seriously, I look forward to facing against these competitors for a very long time. But I'm going to let my boy talk because what a match.
Oh, my God. I'm not even going to lie. Bogz, if you can hear me, that Owls Look a Hole question was the hardest question I've ever heard in this thing.
Oh, really? Our Children Will Not Be Warlords is no longer the hardest one.
No, either way, screw you, Matt. So what I want to say about this match is I've been asking Jonesing for fresh blood in this thing because I got tired of playing the same people, especially the same people that like I want to do teams with stuff later in the future. But oh my God, what a match. I'm pissed I missed those Pixar questions. I knew his the makeup question. I knew Sally was a Porsche. I love cars. That movie rules. But oh my God, I'm shocked. That was GG Bogz. One day I hope we get to play again soon.
So Chris, you will be facing Lou the Artist DiNardo. Are you scared of him at all?
I get to play Lou.
Yes, sir.
Oh snap. No, I mean, I'm not scared per se. I've been asking for Lou. Lou's one of the few people on my short list of people I want to play. Obviously, the Encourager, I want to play him. I want to play the Semen Demon. I want to play, oh God. I want to play the Mystery Man. I want to play, I don't want to play the Wizard at all. But the Artist, on the other hand, is someone I've been asking for. So Lou DiNardo, I'm not scared. I'm not scared.
I had an interview with him the other day, and he said that he is scared of you.
Oh, he's scared of me. Yes. don't be. Don't be. Like, we're out here. We just.
Why are you talking to me like I'm him?
Like, well, tell him whenever you get the chance to talk to him, to not be scared of me. I'm just a guy. I'm just out here rocking, trying to do my best, having fun while I'm doing it. I had a blast today. This was a riot. Quick shout out, Colin Morris. I understood your Civil War II poll. I understood that for all the nerds back in the books. I get you. But yeah, I'm not scared of Lou, but at the same time, I'm excited to play him. It's gonna be a lot of fun.
Okay.
I want to say that it's so much fun to talk trash, but I'm really excited to have all these new opponents on here. Like, seriously.
Yeah.
Like, I was trying to take on like a Bobby Gucci this match just to have fun and just talk shit. But like, seriously, it is great that we have these new competitors. We're really excited. And you know, there's a lot of teams that start off 0-2, and I hope that it continues, so we continue to win and we continue to dominate this league. The kids at heart, we're coming for all the belts, right?
I want to do everything that this league has to offer. And
right.
Oh, and before I forget, I did mention my shortlist of a few people, and the Mouth of the South. You can go ahead and jot your name down on that list as well, because it's on my shortlist, baby. Let me rephrase. The phony South of the Mouth.
Thank you.
Because Jimmy Hart, I don't know how he feels about moving trivia. But
the kid at Hart loved Jimmy Hart, so
Hart love Jimmy Hart for obvious reasons. But let's do some more really trivia over here, and then we'll worry about Jimmy Hart later. We'll worry about that in WrestleRia.
That's right.
All right. Well, let's bring these guys back on. Colin, Bogz, great first showings this week. Proud of you both. I know you two are practicing, so they're telling me about it. So, those wins are coming.
Yeah, I probably just going to give you a better match, but next time.
Okay, you guys next time. Signing off, I'm Matt. That's Douglas Parcells. And this was another Who Are They?